get your motor running. Head out on the highway.
Sergeant Dave Porteous is driving into trouble.
And whatever comes our way.
He's hoping for an easy ride, but life is never easy in the custody suite.
Fingers crossed. The last thing you want to do on your first day back at work after 3 days off is to come back to it all being absolutely mentally near.
Can we get someone down here, please?
A regular visitor is trying to commit suicide.
She just stuffed a toilet roll down her throat.
And not for the first time.
Yeah, can you speak to us?
Call me an ambulance.
Every single member of staff is trying to save her.
She's got something like toilet roll, knotted it all together, and I think she's either put some in her mouth, in her throat, and then tied some round her neck. She's
stuffed some down her throat.
No, she's tried to strangle herself. She's unconscious.
Welcome to the lockup.
That's the sound of the police. That's the sound of the beast. That's the sound of the police.
Hull is home to a quarter of a million people, and Humberside Police has no shortage of regular visitors.
Literally just been released. Yeah, I've been out 10 minutes and locked up 10 minutes later after getting out of a cop car into another one.
One in four criminals in the UK re-offend within a year.
Look at this.
And we've seen lots over the past 6 months.
That's the sound of the police.
Yep, will do.
They reached the suicidal woman just in time. This is her second visit to custody in a week. This time, she's been arrested for burglary.
Have you sorted someone off? Just the ambulance staff and they get you to check you out, make sure you're okay. All right. And make sure your throat's okay after doing that.
Detention officer Vicky has saved her life.
It's a little surreal at the moment. It doesn't feel as if it's happened while I've been here and it wasn't me that actually did that. It's a little odd. Came in, she had been under a blanket most of the day, and when I do my checks, I was getting to check that she was fine, and she had been. So I pulled the blanket back, just expecting her to be upset like she was, and she was just literally on her back, red in the face, with toilet tissue just stuffed into her mouth and up her nose. And like I say, that's when I didn't even start. I thought, I need help. That's when I pressed the emergency buzzer outside and then just came back in and started pulling it out as quick as I could. And that's when I noticed that she'd got something tied around her throat. At first, I thought it was toilet roll again, but I couldn't get my fingers through it. So I shouted for some scissors, and what she'd done was she'd had a T-shirt on and she'd ripped the bottom of the T-shirt off and she'd wrapped it around her throat several times. I was due to come and check on her again in 5 minutes. Would that have been too late? It's quite scary. If I'm going to sit and start analysing it like that, I think that's quite scary.
When someone attempts suicide in custody, they're usually given a mental health assessment. Sergeant Porteous has seen this all before.
Some people do it every time they come in. You know, it's not uncommon. People try it because it's usual for them to self-harm. People try it because they just don't like being locked up and they just think it's a way out. There are some people that just genuinely can't help themselves, and this could be just another one of those cases, really.
Yes, she's got a bit of swelling on the throat.
Yeah.
Is it still hurting inside? No? I'm just going to tell them, you know.
Well, don't.
Can't be more than 10 minutes.
You can never remove all the risks. When all's said and done, she's in a cell. It's got concrete walls and a concrete floor. I mean, if she wanted to, she could get up and run face first into the wall and hurt herself if that's what she was really determined to do that.
For now, the ambulance man has decided the woman doesn't need to go to hospital.
Right.
There's nothing there. Apart from a bit of bruising, but on the outside, where she's just had it tight.
Yeah.
You know, I can leave her in the cell, do some ops on, just keep an eye on her.
Yeah, that's fine, mate, if you want to do that.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine by me. I'll just be guided by you.
The detainee is on suicide watch until a decision is made whether to charge her for the burglary. At check-in, there's another regular in the lockup. This will be Andrew Oakes' second visit in 3 days.
Just get these off him, it's killing me out. Well, look, fucking look at him, they're bleeding. He fucking threw me out of the handcuffs in the van. Ridiculous, man.
Since 2005, Andrew has been arrested 50 times. He's an alcoholic with an ASBO that bans him from harassing anyone in East Yorkshire or entering a long list of shops.
When he's had a drink, he feels he can go into any shop, take any bottle of alcohol from a shelf and leave with it without paying. And if he's challenged, he'll just laugh at the staff and run off. And that's most ideal, because it's for shop theft.
This time, Andrew's been done for a bottle of wine.
Any comments made? Cooperative?
No,
it's up and down.
A bit hostile to start.
Bit hostile. That's all that means.
I've known Andy 5 years because he's one of the first people I ever met when I started the job. So I've got a pretty good rapport with him, and he has got a drink problem, simple as. It is frustrating when you're trying to get somebody to help, because he'd be a different guy again, I think, if he obviously sorted his problem out.
But he hasn't sorted his problem. Alcoholics are very unpredictable.
Andrew,
I've
got to speak to you, please.
He snatched me on
here. Now Andrew will also be charged with assaulting an officer.
Oh! You
dirty bastard.
We're innocent, all right. I'm all right.
Being gobby might not get you into trouble, but gobbing certainly will.
It's just disgusting. It's absolutely disgusting. There's no excuse for it. I'm here doing my job, and he just spits on me. He wants to be treated like a human being, and he comes in and acts like an animal. So if he wants to act like an animal, treat him like one. I've been spat at before. I'll no doubt get spat at again.
I think Dave got the rough end of the stick there, to be fair to Dave.
Are you consoling yourself?
I am.
Do you need to talk to somebody?
I've been God done, so now I need to eat.
What's your favourite stuff from the store thing? Can't imagine that's...
Quite nice,
actually. It is. I'm surprised.
It's got a cheeky little barbecue sauce on it.
Ooh.
Cheeky.
Oaksy.
What are you doing here again?
I haven't breached me. I've bought a lunch from a factory, haven't you?
Have you been in a garage where there's been a shop in there?
No. I didn't do no wrong. I was kicking off, because I didn't do no wrong. Honestly.
Mate, you're never going to change. You're always going to be here for the rest of your life, aren't you?
No.
You had, last time you said that, and the time before you said that, and then you end up here every other week now.
This time, I'm here for now. I know I haven't reached it. Can you do me a favour? Can you ring my mum for me? Let her know I'm in here.
Did you ask for your mum to be informed when you came in?
I did, yeah.
I'll go check the log since she's been ringing up.
All right,
man. All right, man.
Someone else who's been hammering the booze is on his way to the lockup, and there are rumours he may be Starkers.
Wonder how naked this man's nakedness is
going to
be.
No idea. We shall see.
We shall not shout.
I might well be far.
Come on, buddy.
I'm hoping not for a howling lunatic.
Come on!
Okay.
Evening.
Hello.
Have you been in custody before?
Yes.
Yes. What offence are we here for?
It depends what I've done that hurts.
Stand up.
What depends on what that hurts?
It wasn't disorderly until...
Circumstances, please.
You're seen urinating against the shop window.
20.
When he's approached by police officers, he dropped his trousers, leaving his pants
really?
Up.
It's a video.
Calling him all numpties and telling them all to fuck off.
What?
I want to see this video.
He was detained, tried to take
I definitely want to see his video.
Home address, but there's nobody who was at home address.
Scarborough.
So he's been arrested for being drunk and disorderly.
Definitely Scarborough. This fucking hurt. Definitely hurts.
Michael Lawler can't string a coherent sentence together.
Gorgeous muscles.
Prompt effect.
It definitely hurts. Ah.
If you start being compliant, the push can come off, can't they?
That's fine. I'm more than compliant.
Right.
I've still had it in my eyes.
He gives a whole new meaning to blind drunk.
For the green, I'm not moving, so I'm off record. Definitely still on video. Yes, Michael, since legally changed. Michael, since legally changed to Mike, M-I-K-E-L. It's now
Michael.
30th, which was when I changed my legal date of birth. M-I-C-A, please don't laugh.
Simon, you're not answering my question.
Well,
what's your date of birth?
My old date. My old date.
What's your current date of birth?
The current, as of this current date, here and now. M-I-C.
That's not your date of birth.
That's not a date.
Oh, sorry. No, you're right. 30th of January, since my legal shit. No, all right. Go on. Please correct me, please.
Michael, I
don't
ask myself as white British. What do you class yourself as?
Yeah, well, white British.
Yeah.
But I'm not racist at all.
I didn't ask you if you were racist.
No, I just wanted to clarify for the record.
Okay, that's fine.
Right, you know the pocket that you keep your shit in? You can carry it, if not, like, the tiny little pocket. But it might have a condom in it.
Michael, can you read and write?
Can I read the light?
Can you read and write?
Oh, can I read and write? When I've got my eyes open, yeah, which I currently do not.
No, that's fine, so normally you can. How much alcohol have you had tonight, Michael?
In units?
As in, how many drinks do you think you've had?
From the high street? I have no idea. My left hand is going from, well, literally the sky, the counter.
A lot.
From
the in the will to live now.
Follow that lady there. I'm
practice walking in that direction there.
Michael, Mike. Lawler is a law unto himself.
Can you have a drink?
He
had a drink.
He might have had a drink. So he should be fit next Thursday. Sunday today, sober by Thursday, I would have thought. Spectacular little kid.
Worky, worky. Right. You're going to need booking in. When you came in, you was a bit of an ass, so you need a full booking.
Right. Off we go. I'm not used to going to it.
Andrew is now sober enough to be processed.
Thank you.
He's still adamant he didn't breach his ASBO, banning him from local shops and garages.
Oh, no, I haven't breached it. Just walking along, got arrested for now. I got locked up for the same thing the other night. Went to court Saturday and they let me out on a final chance and they've got me again last night. Might as well have stayed in custody all pissing weekend. Can't win.
Thank you.
Pissed off. Shouldn't be in here.
CCTV tells a different story.
Well, the worst thing about that, you can't even remember it, can you?
I can't remember. So I'll be back to jail tomorrow now, then.
I'm sorry, mate.
You see
somebody about that drink,
man.
It's fucking stupid, isn't it? And it's social
anchors. Do you want to see somebody
about
the drink?
I wouldn't mind, Jeff. Tell a nurse to
come
and see a nurse, boss.
What's the nurse for?
I'm not feeling so well.
Yeah, but the what? Just feeling with nurse, are you not feeling too well? What's the matter with you?
I just feel shit, headaches and that.
Is that because you're withdrawing?
A bit, yeah.
Do you want me to have a word with the alcohol worker for you?
Yeah, if you can.
But you can't end up coming here. How old are you now?
35.
That's what I mean. You don't want to spend the rest of your days coming here, everybody, over there, do you? Yeah. Plenty of fluid down your neck.
Aye.
Aye.
It's my own fault, innit? It's just a beer when I'm pissed. I don't know what I'm doing sometimes. It messes me up. Proper does. It's been daft. Now what I can do about it now I'm in here.
The woman who tried to commit suicide is now being charged with burglary.
She's not liking being in here at all. And unfortunately, she wants to go home, but the way she's behaving and her actions, it's just delaying.
the inevitable.
But when she hears the charge, the woman kicks off. And in her cell, she lashes out violently. It takes five people to strap her down.
Stronger than me.
She's not physically the biggest person, but we're not fighting with her. We're trying to restrain her. It's a bit different because she can do what she likes and, you know, put her arms under her body and tense herself, and we have to be, you know, we can use force, but we still have to be mindful of what we're doing.
Right, we'll try and get her legs together.
One, two, three, stop! Just do it!
With 55 previous convictions, this woman is no stranger to violence. The officer's main aim is to protect her from herself.
Relax, I'm gonna pop your hair again. Fucking relax!
The doctor said about breathing. You slow down. You don't need to hyperventilate this here because you'll end up. So nobody's trying to hurt you, we're trying to stop you hurting yourself, okay? Just calm down a little bit. Well, this is unnecessary, isn't it?
Calm down!
Nobody needs to have any handcuffs or straps, but you need to calm down. Alright? Slow it down. Just slow it down, okay? Just relax.
I'll never understand what goes on in their heads, really, as to why people want to behave like that. But this is part of the reason this job's so interesting. Our young lady seems to have settled down a little.
You're at 10:30.
Can only have that sort of energy for so long.
She's back on cell watch.
And if things get too bad, then we just have an officer sat at the cell door with the cell door open, just physically watching them, constant supervision all the time. We just have to play it by ear, essentially. Every case is different. You can't just be generic about people that come in and self-harm.
Officer Dayton has drawn the short straw.
It's tense for the officer, because if the person you're watching hurts themselves, you're there to try and stop that happening. It's quite exhausting mentally and physically, because you just got to keep watching them all the time. There's no rest. There's no time to take your eye off the ball, if you like, especially on a night shift. On a night shift, it is an exercise in concentration, to be fair.
Most of the guests in the lockup have now bedded down.
And the king's head, Beverly.
Except for one. Mike, Michael Lawler, is wide awake. And talking to an invisible friend.
Is there a conversation with somebody in the
looks of it? I'm glad it's not me that's going to have his head in the morning, but he'll probably sleep for a fair few hours.
Mike Michael Lawler is exercising his right to exercise. Outside, a band of lads are awaiting their entrance.
Oh, Christ.
They were arrested on their way to a McDonald's drive-thru. All they wanted was a McFlurry. But they ended up with a very unhappy meal.
Yeah, there's four. I think police theft of a motor vehicle. If we have one up here and then one in the waiting.
And then two outside.
Yeah, two outside. Yeah, that's fine. We'll just feed them through as it went.
Morning. You've been in custody before?
Do you understand why you've been arrested?
No.
Suspicion of theft. Suspicion of stealing a motor vehicle.
Yeah, it's quite hilarious.
And circumstances, please.
Saw this vehicle initially. It drove up quite some speed, certainly well in excess of 30, so we've tried to follow the vehicle. We invited the vehicle to stop with the blue lights and it didn't stop at first, so we thought we'd got to fail to stop. He then pulled into the McDonald's car park where once we got the vehicle, we came back to check the registration number. Just stand there. Check the registration number, it's come back, there's no trace. So we believe the vehicle to be stolen, there's no record of its existence at the current time.
I think you need to concentrate on what's happening here, mate.
Right. No.
Calvin Knowles isn't taking the matter very seriously. And it's only going to get worse.
Just let you know, fella, that you're also under arrest on suspicion of possession of cannabis, OK? So just a reminder that you are still under the caution. Cannabis was found in the car, so until we decide who it is, you're also further under arrest for that, OK?
To make matters even worse, Calvin's revealing his one pack to the nation. A lot of Happy Meals been in there.
What's that?
Something for the ladies there on the camera.
Do you want to get your top, mate?
Number two in is Chris.
Driving licence and that.
What is it?
I don't know, it's just a novelty from Manchester I bought.
Looks like a Hoover.
Third in line is George.
Just to let you know as well, is that also, when we searched the vehicle was searched and some cannabis was found in there, so
right.
You've also been arrested on suspicion of possession. Suspicion of cannabis, OK, so just to mind you are still under caution for that.
All right, then.
OK.
Fourth and last is Jack.
Do you understand why you've been arrested?
Was it for theft of motor vehicle?
That's the allegation, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Do you have any mental health problems?
No.
Do you have any allergies, specific dietary needs?
I'm allergic to cats.
Can't see many cats going in.
Dietary needs.
Two keys and a fob.
Stay safe.
Bank card.
Yep.
Two flavoured condoms.
Mint. I'll put the mint in it.
Minty fresh.
Just in case, you know.
Right, if you
want
to come this way, I'll take it to yourself.
Right.
Now settled in, Calvin's protesting his innocence.
I went into McDonald's and that's when all the bobbies rolled up in about five cars just to me. And I wasn't even doing anything and they handcuffed me straight away. I even done out.
Would you like a sandwich? Cheese or ham?
And life's dealing Jack another hard blow. When the custody suite menu doesn't quite live up to McDonald's.
There you go.
I only wanted a McFlurry, and we was like so close. But yeah, so I had to put up with a Kit Kat instead.
He's not the only one with food on his mind.
I've got a bit of chocolate cake in the fridge I've been thinking about all night and I had time to eat. We're all robots really in here, we don't actually need food, but we have to eat it to look human.
People have said before I have strange eating habits. If you don't have a chance to eat till 3, 4, and 5 in the morning, you don't really fancy a Sunday dinner. So that's why I bring porridge or cereal or something. So, or otherwise you end up eating rubbish. Like the poor. Like you with your chips.
Makes me happy.
The lads are now ready to be processed. Two of them have already tested negative in a drugs test. And now it's one pack Calvin's turn.
Convict now, kid.
Doesn't mean you're a convict at all.
Detention officer Laura is being deadly serious.
I don't want to do a drugs test on you. It tests for cocaine and heroin, so I need you to put that little cotton bud in your mouth for me and leave it there until I tell you to take it out.
but it's still one big joke for Calvin.
Calvin, can I just get you to come over here, please? I just want to do your fingerprints. Send me your left hand, please.
Have you done your hair then, Lise? Tell us.
No, I've just got long hair and I'm not allowed to have it down, so it gets put up. Calvin, keep your wrist loose for me. Calvin, I don't need your help. I appreciate you trying to help, but I don't need the help. It just makes the machine beep.
No, but serious, aren't you?
Yep. Calvin, it needs a signature from yourself in that panel there, please. Yeah. Just to state that your prints. If you go and sit back down on the grey chair, please.
That's put him in his place.
As I'm sure you expected, that's come back as negative. I swear.
Last in line is Jack.
I'd like to keep a representation of
There's a noticeable change in atmosphere. And the conversation is flowing.
You just don't know what you're looking for.
Say. Can you tell that I'm nervous?
I get the impression you are.
I'm like, I don't know. It's just, I wasn't expecting this. Like, I only went to get a McFlurry. And I've ended up spending a night in a cell.
Did you get a McFlurry?
No, I didn't get one.
Oh, like, good.
It was nearly at the drive-thru.
Good. Are they still 99p?
I think so, but, like, if you want a special edition one, it's an extra 19 pence.
You come back as negative.
What does that mean? I'm guilty.
No, sweetheart, it means you've got nothing in your system.
Because I did go to Amsterdam about 2 weeks ago.
I love Amsterdam. I've been a number of times.
Yeah.
You just like the red light district.
I didn't go down the red light district. My mum might be watching.
Okay. So everybody else, that means it did.
Jack the lad is living up to his name.
Grab a shoe. You can carry it back, I carried it here. Pop this way.
It's a match made in Hull. As the sun rises over the lockup, Sergeant Porteous and his team ready themselves for yet another repeat offender. They know 18-year-old Emma Keneally really well.
Get off me!
They're not
going to
get off you while you're shouting.
Get the fucking out!
Do you want to stand up for us, please?
No!
Otherwise, these officers will look at you.
She's been arrested for assault after downing a bottle of vodka.
Get out of my fucking bed!
We just want to hook you in, don't we, Emma Rawlix, whichever you mean.
Calm down.
Are you going to calm down?
Get out of my bed!
Just calm down.
Oh, no,
you sure as you can calm down and look like
this? I can't.
No, you're not.
You're going to have to stand here and just calm down.
I want to get out of it.
They should be named as a suspect, I'll just...
I didn't
mind.
You dirty.
You also locked up for assault, please.
It's the spitting season in the lockup. Emma is now up for assault.
It does make you angry. If somebody's going to punch you, you get warning signs where you can see them clenching the fist and you know something's going to happen. You can sort of move out the way, but if somebody just turns around and spits in your face, there's absolutely nothing you can do about it apart from restrain them and point them away from you so it doesn't happen again.
But in Emma's case, it does happen again and again and again.
Oh, yeah, spits at officers.
Yeah, she's feral. It's nothing like being slapped or punished or anything like that. It's very invasive. It's full of germs. You can't really describe how horrible it actually feels when it all lands in your face.
For Officer Dayton, it's been a long night. His time on suicide watch is coming to an end.
I've been dealing with the young lady for 8 hours, and I just want to go home and go to bed.
All right, mate, cheers. Thank you.
He leaves as she goes to court. On average, every year in the UK, four people commit suicide in police custody.
No problem. See you later. See ya.
The sergeant's relieved to see the back of her.
The law of averages says that regardless of what happens, at some point in time, somebody is going to come into custody, and for no fault of anybody's, they are going to die. But hopefully, you know, it doesn't happen when I'm on.
When detainees behave, they may be granted a bit of fresh air in the custody yard. It's Andrew Oakes' turn.
Well, you want to need to get off it then, don't you? As we've said numerous times, do it for your mum. Well, she doesn't want you to be in here, does she?
She's sick of it.
You can change that, though. Nobody else.
In and out. They're sick of the sight of me in there. Fucking hell.
It's all drunk-related.
You'll
be used to me that you're sick of all this.
I am.
But why did you stop then?
It was just last night. I've intended to lately. Just last night I was...
So why did you have a drink yesterday then?
Because it was Saturday.
Is it not as easy as that just to stop?
Don't you drink?
But I know when to stop, don't I? Because I haven't known you 5 years, have I? For 5 years,
right.
You've been in and out here like I don't know bloody what.
For daft things as well, innit?
Well, it's all drink with you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Until you sort that out, you're always going to be coming in here, aren't you?
Since I got off the gear and that, I've been a right mess.
Was you on the drugs as well?
Heroin, yeah.
Was you? Was that hard to get off?
Proper.
Oh, yeah.
Horrible. And I got off it about a year ago. Just been pissing it up since then. It's just night time when I've had a few during the day and I haven't had no tea and that, and you just keep going.
Where do you get your money from for it all? Do you nick your nick for it?
I have been, yeah.
You kick the drugs, you just need to kick this one now then, don't you?
Yeah, don't we?
Well, you'll start turning your life around, but it's up to you. I'm sure your mum don't want that.
Oh, if I was out there now, I'd be on that. Maybe the Westwood chilling out.
What, with a can of beer?
Yeah.
I thought there'd be a beer involved somewhere.
But offending also seems to be a habit, so there's little hope that this will be the last time that Andrew checks in.
All right.
Cheers.
All right. See you later, mate.
I don't know whether we're keeping the cell warm for him, but I'm sure there'll always be space for him when he comes back. It'd be rude not to have a cell waiting, really.
Fellow spitter, Emma Keneally, has calmed down and wants to phone home.
Is that if I ring my dad? Please.
Yes.
In the lockup, guests are entitled to have someone informed of their detention.
I'm just ringing on behalf of Emma. She'd like to have a chat with you. Is that in order with yourself? All right, excellent. I'll just pass you over now. All right, thank you. Bye-bye.
Hey. Could you get me my cuff jeans? What, in my bedroom? Yeah, do you know the dark blue ones? I'm sorry. I don't remember anything, though. It's not all right, though, is it? I am sorry, though. All of you. Bye.
Thank you.
Cheers.
I think it's Jekyll and Hyde syndrome. It's quite prevalent, really. People come in absolutely plastered, want to take on the world, want to fight with everybody. 9 times out of 10. I would say that when they've slept it off, they become a lot more polite. And most of them are OK. They're very calm. They're easy to be dealt with.
It's checkout time for three of the likely lads. But Calvin's still awaiting his fate. He thinks it's all down to an error in his new car's registration documents.
One digit missing, that's why I think I've been registered, which I was going to rectify and actually send the logbook back off and obviously get that fixed.
And his story checks out.
He
He's just recently come by the vehicle. He's saying it's his own registration number, which is just transferred to that vehicle, but unfortunately, with going to the DVLA and actually updating those details, that's not being done. So the officers, I think, were quite right in obviously stopping the vehicle and arresting them.
So they're going to be unconditionally released. And you can join your friends out in the front.
Don't know if I'd give another autograph.
I've just signed £1 million over to me.
They've all been let off for the drugs too. The cannabis could have been in the car before Calvin bought it.
Just remember, kids, before you do the crime, think about the time.
I think when they come into custody, they do think it's something special. It's a badge of honour. They can go back and tell their mates, you know, how good am I? I got locked up last night for whatever. And, some like it, some think it's great.
It's like this.
They're already rehearsing their tale.
Open door! Get out, you criminal! Go!
Something like that, it was like, done in 20 seconds.
Right, see you later, guys.
Yeah, we've been here long enough.
With that, Sergeant Dave Porteous is free to hit the road too.
The job is confined into custody, and there's nothing I need to take home. And once you leave, you pass it over, and that's it, really.
The woman who attempted suicide pleaded guilty to burglary and was given a 12-month supervision order.
You won't ever see me in here again in my life, any of them. After this time, that's it. I'm smitten man up overnight. Simple as.
Serial offender Andrew Oakes was charged with breaching his ASBO and assaulting a police officer. He got 2 18-week jail sentences. Gibbering wreck Mike Michael Lawler had to pay an £80 fine for being drunk and disorderly.
Do you have much recollection of what happened yesterday?
Not really anything.
At least he left the lockup fully clothed.
I'm sorry, Lawler.
For spitting, Emma Keneally served 8 weeks in a juvenile detention unit.
Everything all right with you?
The band of four lads headed straight for the drive-thru, never to be seen in the lock-up again. Hopefully. Next time in the lock-up, Sergeant Grunner is on the beat.
It's that samba beat. You could shut your eyes. We could be in Brazil.
Hey, just leave him alone!
His team is on a prisoner. Politics are on the agenda.
I'm just in the Labour Party and Labour's working.
Have any medical condition?
No, I'm not Max Pro-Communist.
No,
I'm not Max Pro-Communist.
And one gent's almost on the limit.
Apparently someone reported me for drink driving.
Brand new comedy next tonight on BBC One with self-proclaimed community leader and man of the people, Citizen Khan.